What if I told you that your laptop can be fast, efficient, thin and lightweight, and upgradable and repairable too? Well, it can, and we can prove it, because we have the first look at the awesome new tech that makes it possible. We've teamed up with Micron and Lenovo to give you a hands-on demo of LPCAMM2, a new memory standard that we've been hearing about for a long time, and crossing our fingers that it wasn't vaporware. And we're really excited to be the first to tell you, it's real. We'll get to that in a second, but first, how in the heck did we get to a place where laptop memory couldn't be repaired or upgraded? Well, laptop makers had painted themselves into a corner trying to solve a series of tough technical problems. For repairability, they could use trusty old SODIMM RAM sticks, which are socketed and easy to replace, just like in a desktop PC. But SODIMM RAM is bulky and power-hungry, and it's a 25-year-old standard that's just not staying competitive. Lately, laptop makers have been opting for LPDDR, or low-power DDR memory chips, which are small and efficient. But because they sip so little power, they have to be soldered very close to the central processor, or they start to lose signal integrity. Like, if low-power Sharam were here to whisper this part of the video to you, we'd have to move uncomfortably close, or you couldn't hear anything he says. Low-power Sharam also wasn't repairable or upgradable, which is why we had to let him go. Anyway, that's where LPCAMM2 comes in. Standing for Low Power Compression Attached Memory Module, LPCAMM2 uses the same LPDDR memory chips that sip tiny amounts of power, but they're soldered onto a PCB, kind of like a RAM stick, that's cleverly designed to mount right up next to the CPU with very short traces to help maximize signal integrity. This is a really cool technical solution to a tough set of problems, and it's repairable and upgradable just like conventional RAM. Or at least that's what we've been promised for what feels like forever, but we haven't actually seen it until today. Check this out. This is the newest Lenovo ThinkPad P1 workstation, and it's the first laptop you can actually buy that uses the LPCAMM2 module, with Micron being first to supply it. Other manufacturers will be able to use it as well, but Lenovo and Micron worked together to be the first. And because iFixit has an existing business relationship with both companies helping to get repairable products out into the world, they were nice enough to send it here first. Unfortunately, they said we can't open this up. Just kidding. Check this out. The procedure for getting inside this particular ThinkPad is somewhat beside the point for our purposes today, but if you're curious, we've already published the guide for how to do it on iFixit.com. Remove 6 screws, pop some clips, take off the bottom cover, easy peasy. Then we unscrew and disconnect the battery. And there it is, the LPCAMM2 module. It's small, it's thin, and it's really not complicated to remove and replace. These 3 captive Phillips screws can be loosened in any order, and then you just lift it out. Underneath is the compression connector, which is also replaceable, and it's helpfully keyed to help you install it in the correct orientation. Put it all back together and simply tighten the screws in the order shown. Easy as 1, 2, 3. And there we have it, the world's first documented LPCAMM2 replacement. It's more performant than the old SODIMM sticks, more efficient, it saves space, and it should even help with the thermals. All that, and it's still about as repairable as anything we've ever seen. We also like LPCAMM2 better than Apple's unified memory implementation, which plops the memory chips right onto the CPU package for even shorter traces and tighter integration, but it's the least repairable solution of all. Very cool tech on all sides here, but we'll take the repairable, upgradable option every time. P.S. Apple has been taking a beating in the press for the stingy 8 GB of memory you get on an entry-level MacBook Pro, and we won't wade into that argument here, other than to say 8 GB would be fine if upgrading later were an option. With LPCAMM2, you can do that. Obviously, we're excited about this, but what's even more awesome is that our industry partners are also excited, and for all the right reasons. They've made repairability a headline feature. Here's our friends at Micron.
It's so comfortable to continue using what, quote, isn't broken, right? We invested so much in it. Everybody knows how to use it. Why would you change, right? And so it really does take true pain points to force the market to do things like this. On the consumer side, the downside is once you buy the laptop, if you say, okay, well, this was great when I bought it, but a year later, it's like, you know what? Actually, I want to run this program. I've decided I've gotten into video editing and I need another 16 gigs of RAM. That's it. It's soldered down. You got to buy a new one. We've essentially engineered it to be obsolete when people's expectations of what they need to use it for change. And so the challenge is, okay, how do we maintain the serviceability of the module, but making sure that it's built in such a way to address what we know devices need for the next 10 to 20 years, right? We're not the only people on the market. We have to do a good job. Micron has to, have to continue doing a good job of promoting why we believe this is the right path. That's how we get to a place where it's universally accepted.
For a more in-depth technical explainer on what's happening underneath the hood of LPCAMM2, check out our blog post on iFixit.com. This really does seem like the future, but we'll have to wait and see how many other laptop OEMs follow Lenovo's lead. I also think LPCAMM2 could use a more exciting moniker to help advertise its benefits. Super memory, LPDDR Pro, compression attached awesomeness. Give us your ideas in the comments. For now, I think I'll call it the Completely Repairable Awesome Memory Project, or CRAMP. No, maybe the Awesome Memory... I'll work on it.